So I'm starting to break out in a couple of places, which usually means my period's gonna show up in a few days. But it did make me think about how, in a time where we have all sorts of acceptance movements and pride movements for different facets of our identity and of our appearance and our bodies, there isn't really such a thing as acne pride. Like most teenagers, I had really severe acne growing up. I was often told to deal with my acne in some way. Both my mom and my dad wanted me to start using skincare products. I'd been to the doctor a couple of times. You'd have the effect of walking down the shopping mall and having sales girls run after you. Miss, for your skin, miss, leave me alone. The cumulative effect of that, especially the fact that it was always framed as there's something wrong with you and you have to fix it to be accepted, it just turned me off the whole skincare thing. I mentioned in an earlier video about how frustrated I was that my accomplishments or my interests or my skills were being ignored in favor of my appearance or the lack thereof. So I ended up pushing skincare stuff to the absolute bottom of the priority list. Screw skincare, screw makeup, screw everything. I don't care. I want you to like me for me, not how I look. So I just stopped giving a damn after a while. And then I gained an interest in the media and gained interest in performing and presenting. There is a lot of focus placed on your appearance, especially on having clear skin. It wasn't enough that my skin was already kind of dark by Malaysian standards. It was also acne ridden. So I would get passed over simply because of how I looked. Like I would audition for things and I would see like on their markup, they'll have bad skin. I've been thinking about the acne pride thing for a little while. You know, like they're this growing fat acceptance movement, which is awesome, which is great. Health at every size, and how one of their big tenets is that you can't assume why people are fat. Like they could be fat, yeah, maybe because it's a diet thing. I'm not, maybe they're just born like that, maybe it's a medical issue. The point is, it shouldn't matter. You should still value them as human regardless of what size they are. And then you have like a lot of people with visible disabilities, especially ones that affect the way you look, reclaiming that and speaking out about that. There has been some stuff around skin, like there is Chantel Brown Young who got on Top Model and had vitiligo. And now she's getting a lot of respect and a lot of raves for doing really well in spite of her vitiligo. But you don't really see anything about acne. There's no acne pride movement, or at least not the last few times I've Googled for it. You don't see people kind of championing for the right to not have to fix your acne, the right to not have clear skin if you don't want to, and to still be respected for your contributions anyway. And there's still this assumption being made that, oh, if you have acne, it means you don't take care of your skin, you don't care about yourself. Does that sound at all familiar to you? Last year, I was part of a photo project by this pretty awesome queer POC photographer named Heidi Andrea. She sent me the photo proofs and I had no makeup on. I was just being myself. There's this one photo, it's just black and white, and you see every last acne scar. Bit like freckles, except more intense. And yet it looked really, really dignified. I was very stunned because that was the first time that I'd ever seen a picture of someone with acne not as a before photo. And I asked her about it and I said, wow, this is, I'm really taken aback by the photos where you could clearly see the acne on my skin. And she said, yeah, I wanted to just portray who I am without retouching. And me without retouching also means me with acne scars. And yet she gave so much respect to the acne scars. And that was the thing I'd never seen before, was anyone actually respecting the acne. And that blew me away. It was hard for me to see the photo because I still had all this internalized stuff about, oh, acne is ugly, acne is horrible, acne blah. But at the same same time, it looked amazing. I would like to start an acne pride movement. You know, like, yeah, fine, I've got spots on my skin. I've got acne that flares up once a month, even though I'm nearly 30. I've got severe case of acne that will never go away. I've got acne and I'm trying to treat it. I've got acne and I don't want to treat it. I've got acne and nothing works to treat it. I've got acne and I'm a teenager. Many other teenagers have acne and it's not news. I've never had acne as a teenager, but now I do, and it's weirding me out a little. I've got acne everywhere else. I used to have acne. I may still get acne. That should be fine. Clear skin does not need to be the only marker of a worthwhile person. Even if my entire face was just one big acne boil, I should still get as much respect and worthiness as every other person on the planet. I would like to invite you all who are watching this to share me your photos of acne. It doesn't have to be professionally taken. I lucked out on mine. You know, it could be selfie, be a webcam photo, could be a photo from childhood, could be a photo now. Let's show each other our acne scars. Acknowledge that they exist. Pass the word. If this takes off, I might do a collection of photos. I might turn to a bigger project. I don't know yet. Let's have some acne pride. Talk to me on the various links down there. Share with me your photos and your stories. And thank you for watching.